This is Alex. Alex is the founder of a new company, Startup. As the founder, Alex will make decisions about what the organization will look like, including who to hire and who should report to whom. Alex will have a vision for how the organization should work.
And yet over time, Startup will take on a life of its own as newcomers organize to get their work done.
Understanding the difference between formal, machine-like designs for organizations
and the informal, emergent reality of organizing and organizational life is a key goal of systems approaches to organizational communication.
Social network analysis is a set of techniques and theories useful for studying organizations as systems.
Network analysis involves mapping of relationships between individuals. For example, this is a visual representation of the formal structure of Startup. As hiring took place, Alex decided to have everyone report directly. The relationship being mapped is who reports to whom. Here, everyone reports to Alex. In the language of social network analysis, these are nodes. Nodes can be anything in a network: individuals, databases, organizations, and so on.
And what connects them are links. Some sort of relationships, like amount of communication, degree of trust, frequency of advice seeking or advice giving, as well as formal supervision. Again, the organizational chart tells the formal story, but in reality, organizational systems tend to be much more organic.
For example, if we collected data about how much these folks communicate with each other, we might see a data set that looks like this. If people email to someone, we put a 1, if not, a 0. So Clara emails Enzo, but Enzo doesn't send messages to Clara. Notice the email messages are directional. Do you see any patterns? No, well, it's hard to if we're looking at the raw data. Network analysis offers us visualization and analytical techniques that help us find patterns in data like these. Let's look at some simple visualizations or sociograms that follow the same logic of the organizational chart we looked at before.
Each person is a node, and we add a link where the data indicates emails flowing. Now, what do you see? Take a moment and jot down a few observations. There are two different teams. Enzo and Clara connect the two teams. Alex is isolated.
Now, to see this point about formal versus emergent organizing, let's look back at what the network data set would look like for formal reporting relationships. The point of this is that the formal and emergent organizing are different. The pattern of relationships are different. Network analysis lets us look at these systems holistically. Let's talk about a few of the main principles involved with network analysis. Network content is what is flowing through the links, while network mode is the channel of the flows. It might be email, it might be speaking in person.
Network density is how much everyone communicates with everyone within the system. A less dense network is more loosely interconnected, fewer links connecting nodes. A highly dense network is one in which there are many links among network members.
If a person is connected to many others, we can describe them as central in the network. Alex is the most central in the formal organizational chart, but not in the emergent system reflected in the flows of emails in the organization. Almost no one emails Alex.
We also have special terms to characterize the links between people. Strength is how strong the relationships are. For example, we could weight the lines based on how much they email each other.
A relationship is symmetrical when it is reciprocated by default. Being someone's sibling is a symmetrical relationship. Likewise, Alex brought Iris in as a business partner, which is by definition a symmetrical relationship. Some relationships are asymmetrical, meaning they're not reciprocated by default. Iris can email Alex without Alex emailing back. But if Iris is Alex's business partner, then by definition, Alex is also Iris's business partner.
Multiplexity asks, what sort of different links are we mapping? Recognizing the email isn't the only set of relationships between these folks. For example, a subset of the company joined a ping pong league, and we could add friendship ties between them to mark the fact that they have work email relationships and outside of work friendship relationships.
We can also look for cliques, subsystems within a network distinguished by a relatively greater flow of information. In Startup, there are two distinct cliques. Just as there are properties of links, there are also properties of nodes.
An isolate is a node with no or very few links. Who is the isolate in this organization? Alex's eyes lit. Alex only communicates with Clara.
A bridge is a group connector who is a member of the group. Who do you think is the bridge in this network? That's right, it's Clara. A liaison is a node who connects one or more cliques without being a member of either.
Here is contractor Hoshue, a communication system analyst who is going to help startups' communication become more effective. The main takeaway is that taking a systems perspective on organizing means looking for ways to compare and contrast the formal, machine-like organization by design, the organization as it exists on paper, and the informal, organic organizing that emerges over time. Network analysis offers powerful tools for understanding organizations as systems.